Welcome everybody. RDM update here, and we got an announcement to make, which is we're changing up our shipping policy for the new year, and we're going to communicate with the community by posting daily collaborative videos where I always try to, in the video, respond to messages, comment on recent developments in other people's posts, and that kind of thing. And just keep it maybe even 7 days a week, hopefully. Try to get a real routine going down to keep these videos coming, to keep everybody informed about what's going on. And really the whole goal is to improve on all of my weaknesses, you know, listen to all the complaints about the store, which are mainly about shipping lead time. It takes me a while to get things out, and just attack that with everything I got to fix that. I'm concluding my break. I'm no longer just liquidating. That was a total failure. I still have all of the stuff I tried liquidating. Nobody bought any of it, for the most part. Almost done with all the shipping. I know it's a big mess here, but this is my lab right here. I'm playing with new ideas to package the stuff, and what I'm finding is a lot of my time, and the reason for shipping delays, is it takes me a while to package something. Like here is not even all of, this is only like 2/3 of a stage 3 clutch. And there's a few extras in here. I have this new product here, my draw bar, extra hard. And I even make my own cross pins that have little lips to help make sure that it doesn't work loose. And there it is, all installed in there. I also make my own the threaded nuts that go on these shafts. They go on the threads there. And that just means it makes it so I don't have to rely on China to get these. And then I can actually supply assembled units. And this is what people want. Also, just for clarity, I know a lot of people don't really understand how these work. So normally there would be a bearing this size on this side. In order to put this wider bearing on, the shaft itself on this side is 5 millimeters longer, because this bearing is 5 millimeters longer. Now, this section of the shaft, you can maybe slightly tell, is a little bit of a cone shape for about 1/2 inch on each end. Here too, it's a slight cone shape. And when you put on a sprocket, or you put on a clutch housing, or the clutch flywheel, I would call it, sometimes it pushes past this keyway, sometimes it barely gets to the end of this keyway. And the difference could be a millimeter or two between the different sprockets and clutches. And it could also depend on how tight you make this nut. I recommend going pretty tight. That way it doesn't really require the keyway to hold. The actual strength of the press will do a lot of the work. But anyways, the point of all that talk is, when you put it all together, it contains these bearings. And if they both go on the least amount they would ever go on, these bearings would sit wider than normal. And if they go on too tight, these bearings could actually sit narrower. Now, I made it so that in its narrowest condition, let's say this sprocket goes on it really deep and this clutch goes on really deep, then you won't really need to run any shims. Now, here's shims here. The shims sometimes come with this little burr, and that just comes off with your fingers. It's really not held on by much. So anyways, you break that off, and that would stack in between the case and the bearing. You'd have to get it on before the bearing. And it sits there up against the outer race. And basically, if there's any gap in between here and your case, it'll make it so that it's all taken up. And you want it to be taken up that way. You don't go and push the clutch for the first time and it goes and shifts this entire assembly towards the clutch, and then your clutch gears don't line up perfectly. Or vice versa, something pushes on this way, and then your clutch gear is almost rubbing against the case. Neither of which situations are good, and you correct that with either these shims here. They can go on this bearing or this bearing. It doesn't really, you know, whatever makes it so the gear is lined up really nice. That's what you want to prioritize. Then there's also this guy here, which can go here underneath the sprocket, the drive sprocket. Actually, the drive sprocket goes on this side. You can see there's a demonstration of one in place. Now, like I said, these are not always required. They're helpful. They're good to have. They're always included. In addition, we have these three spacers. Because this is an extra 5 millimeters out this way, you need to space out the sprocket cover the same amount. This pin that goes in the center up against the ball bearing, it's also a quarter inch longer than normal. You can see the difference there. This piece here, no matter what, stays the same, no changes. And in case people missed it, this groove here is for O-rings. Okay, now that we demonstrated that a little bit, this is the stage 3 clutch. And you can see the spring, I pre-ground this down. I think I'm going to actually start selling them like that. May not be perfect, but it makes it so at least the it should fit right in the case without any further modification. That's what you might need to do, because these coils are thicker. But anyways, a big problem with a lot of reason I had to delay shipping was I had these all in just different boxes of parts. I didn't have them even this far where they were in bags and, you know, at least started to put back together and all. And that would make shipping take way too long. And some of these parts, they may even seem simple, but they're really good at breaking out of bubble envelopes. So these guys here, so I either need to use excessive tape or painstakingly each part taped to a piece of cardboard. Whatever I need to do to make sure they don't rip out of these envelopes. I actually don't like the paper ones, but they were half the price. I do prefer these plastic ones, and I'm getting more in. So the plan is to pre-package everything. Have everything in its boxes, all ready to go, ready to ship, and then put that in inventory. And then stuff that's in this condition where it's technically made, but it's not boxed up, not packaged, like these cams need to have the nuts put on and put in a little bag and, you know, all that kind of stuff. When that's all done, then I'll put in an inventory on the store. So basically we're gonna take almost everything off the store and then relist it in lower quantities, and it'll be listed as it's actually truly packed and truly ready to ship. Like even these clutch plates, I need to sit here and every single one I gotta screw in that M4 by hand, and it's not ready to ship until I do it. And now look at that, there's only 6, 7, 8 screws left. So what happens if I go and sell 10 plates and all of a sudden I'm missing 2 screws? Things like that really hold me up. And then I need to go run to the computer, order the screws, remember whose order was held up. It's not a very good system. You know, essentially I didn't have systems. You know, I'm really good at making parts, I'm really good at designing parts, but the rest of the business stuff, I would give myself a pretty low score. The good news is I recognize that, and I am willing to change. I don't blame the people that chose not to buy directly from me and maybe purchase my item secondhand so they didn't have to deal with my shipping policies and situation. I appreciate the people that also stuck with me. But in any case, we're going to correct this. This should be a win for everybody. The only person this might negatively affect, potentially, would be perhaps Mitch Green, because he really likes my product, which I appreciate, and he, his big selling point or sales pitch was that he would ship my product very quickly. To make sure that this new change doesn't negative affect Mitch, or to minimize that effect, we are going to set up a consignment account with Mitch, and so he's going to have a lot of my product to sell pre-packaged, ready to go. And yeah, that'll help him move a bunch of product and get things going. I still have a lot to sell. I know it looks like a war zone here, but I just shipped 130 packages in a short period of time, and this is what happens. This is what it looks like with my current non-existent system. We are running low on certain products, and yeah, I'll keep you up to date with that. It's like only 3 intakes. Fairly low on covers. And yeah, we're in next update, we're going to talk about crankshafts. And hopefully I'll have this place cleaned up. I got to put a lot of work into cleaning up. Also, on the bottom of any of these videos, try to post comments or questions, or like I said, I'm going to post these videos every single day. And I feel like this is the appropriate place to check up on an order. Say, hey, look, I'm looking for an update on this order status. Any order modifications, or hey, I see this isn't available on your store. Can you put it back up, or when's this going to be back in stock? And I'll try to answer the questions in the comments, and I'll also try to mention the questions in the group. Also, post up any questions that you guys want to, or any topics you want discussed in these videos, and I'll try to discuss it, or like tag me in a post and see what I think about something. And the plan is to try to be more collaborative, work with you guys. Maybe I'll even try to, if I get my skills going with these videos and editing, maybe even no editing, but I'll try to do interviews with people who are enthusiasts in the hobby, or builders, or other business owners, and just anybody, and try to, like I said, keep it collaborative. And I'm going to try to keep these videos coming every single day, even if it's only a 30-second video. This is embarrassing. Look at this mess. We're getting there, though. All right, guys, I need to clean up. And luckily, a lot of this is going into boxes and being shipped to somebody. Off to work. Thanks again, everybody. Talk to you tomorrow.